Welcome back, everybody, the Pro Spartan Gamer, with episode 7 of Rebirth of a Legend on PES 2015 with a mighty Alienardis. And there you see he's just joined Sport Recife in Brazil for the remainder of his first season. Don't know whether he's going to stay there any longer than the 10 games, just depends on how he goes. Manager trust level already at 80, and we haven't even kicked the ball in anger for the Brazilian side yet. This is after the second data patch as well, so we've done it. We've imported and exported teams, so we haven't lost anything. I don't think it's mucked it up too much. The competition structure has gone back to default, so it means that we've got 20 sides back in the Bundesliga, which is a bit annoying. We've changed it back in edit mode, but it doesn't seem to have reset in the Master League, and probably not also. I imagine it's probably not reset in this as well, but we can't look at that at the moment. He's on the bench for this first game, so we'll have to wait and see if he has any involvement. We'll just go straight into it, and when he's involved, we will let you know. So at half-time, Sport Recife have a good lead over Santos. I thought it was going to be a tough game, but they are winning 1-0 here. Don't know if we're going to come on in the second half. We'll have to wait and see. So no, we didn't kick a ball in anger in that first game. We just sat our ass on the bench all game and watched Sport Recife beat Santos 1-0. So no involvement at all for Leonardis. He was told to sit there and watch. Hopefully he will get involved in future games. So one game gone. There's only about 10 left in the season. So he's going to have to get into that side. Where are they in the lead, Sport Recife? They're right down there. 19th, one off the bottom, along with Santos, which is quite surprising, really. I don't know. I'll just assume Santos will be a bit higher up than that. Maybe not in this Brazilian league. So no change to nothing there. Looks a nice kit, though, on Leonardis, but he hasn't been able to add to his career. What's up next, then? I don't know what this negotiation day is all about. It's the last day of the window, that, actually, so obviously is stay at Sport Recife. He's not going to move twice in the window. Forward time. Manager's trust level can't change. Not been involved at all yet. Next game is against Internacional. Is he going to be involved? Substitute again. So once again, we'll have to wait and see whether we're going to kick a ball in anger or not. We're on green this time, so it wouldn't be too bad if we do get a run out. I will show you some action if we do. Otherwise, it's going to be a bit of a boring episode if we're just sat warm in the bench. So, half time in this one. Still no involvement for Leonardis. And once again, Sport Recife have got a priceless goal in their quest to fight away from the bottom of this table. And they are 1-0 up. Will we be involved in the second half? You have to wait and see. If we are, obviously, we'll be back with the action. So another 1-0 win for Sport Recife. And again, no action for Leonardis. That's not good. Does he know he's messing with this manager? He's messing with the king of Sparta, the great godlike figure Leonardis. If he doesn't hurry up and play him, you know, he's going to end up with his head rolling off his shoulders in the manager's office, and Leonardis wouldn't have any second thought about departing head from neck. Sure, he wouldn't with a massive girt sword or something. He is messing with an absolute legend here. He's brought him to the club, and he has to play him. Two games warming the bench is about all that Leonardis is going to tolerate, I'm sure. Needs to play him in the next game, or things might turn a bit uglier. Obviously, good news for Sport Recife. They're climbing away from the bottom of the table, although they're still 19th. But they are catching the pack above them. But I don't think they're going to pull up too many trees this year by the look of it. Still no change to any of that then. What's the next game? Against Goiás. Not sure that's how you say it, but that's what we're going for. Goiás. Substitutes again. I tell you what, he's walking a very thin tightrope here. Who's in the actual side then better than us? Why are we not getting a run out here? 69s and 68s in that defensive midfield position. We are better than them any day of the week. Now get us in that side or I'm going to stab you in the guts. That's what Leonidas is saying to the stupid manager. Anyway, forward time. Manager's trust level 80. How can it be? He's not playing him. Christ's sake. Fed up of looking this stupid championship manager graphic. Let's see what happens then. See if we actually do get to put our boots on and run out on the Brazilian turf. Because at the moment, this is looking like an absolute joke of a move. So, 0-0 here at half time. Still no taste of a game for Leonidas. Getting a bit desperate now. Getting a bit annoying now, to be honest. There's only 10 games left in the season anyway. And if we don't get any involved, we are on. We've got a first taste of action. Here we are on the ball. So 2.5 games in and Leonidas with the number 7 shirt. That's quite nice. Here we are then, picking it up again. Looking to make a little bit of move. Does well, wins it back again. Then loses it. Not good there from Leo. Coming to the end of his debut for Sport Recife. Didn't really do much in that half. Couldn't really get into the game. A few touches, but nothing memorable. Here he is again. Losing ball again. He's not managed to get up to the speed of it. Been a bit of a disappointing 45 minutes, to be fair. He's not exactly done much to impress the coach there. And a boring 0-0 draw against Goas. See what rating we end up with. Probably nothing to write home about, I shouldn't think. Didn't do anything, really. Leonidas, he managed to get a 6 out of it. Well, I think that's generous. I think that's generous for what he'd done in that half, really. Couple passes, lost the ball a couple times. Trying to make things happen. Still in 19th position. Not having a very good season at all. They've only got to get in the top 12 to actually qualify for the Copa Sudamericana. So, well, they're not going to do that now, are they? It's 33 points, so 11 points off that. Pretty poor season from Sport Recife, to be fair. A 19th career appearance for Leonidas. 3 goals, 1 assist. What is up next? We are playing CR Flamengo. Is he involved? We are in the starting lineup. That's good news. Where are we playing? Oh, centre back. Ah, dear. It's the last thing we wanted. We didn't want to come here as a centre back, for God's sake. Well, we're not going to stay there. It's going to be a marauding Liberola centre back, I tell you. He's not going to sit there in ceremony. He should be pushing forward. You know, you've got to expect that from Leo. He's not going to stay back there and just wallow at centre-back and say, yeah, I'm enjoying this. He'll be pushing forward, looking for action, and he'll be going in as hard as nails. Expect there to be cards. Expect there to be blood. Expect there to be tears from the management. As Sport Recife take on CR Flamengo, and we have Leonidas' full debut. There he is coming out. Number 7. Have you ever heard of a number 7 playing at centre-back? Well, he is today. There he is, enjoying the fireworks and that you get at the start of a South American game. Centre back is the position of Leonidas today, and there he is. Straight away wanting the ball and getting it right the way back there. Looking to fire off a thunderbolt. Straight away, he's dropped into a more central midfield position. They've gone a goal up. Nothing to do with Leonidas. It came down the left-hand side of the defence. And, well, there was no way he could get involved with that. And here he is again, Leo. So half-time comes. 1-0 down. Leonidas trying to push forward as much as possible. Without taking too many chances back there. He's had an okay half. He's been involved in some good moves going forward. Wasn't his fault, the goal. Nothing he could do about it. But Flamengo by far the better side. Not a lot of action. Not going to be it when we're playing at centre-back, I'm afraid. We're going to try and make something happen from the back. But obviously it's not always possible. pushed into midfield, and he did make something happen that time. Play from Leonardis, and keeping ball and giving it back simple. That's good football from the centre back. Gets it again, around the corner pass. Gets the return, little simple one. Oh, and then they give it away. Leonardis! Oh, and he nearly got a berry then from sheer persistence and driving forward. It's his first effort on goal in a Sport Recife shirt. The centre back driving forward from the back. Carefree defending, David Luiz-esque. Pushing forward, he left a gap at the back and they put in the second goal there. Leonardis over chance. Oh, and he's forced a save from the keeper. This is what he's got to be playing further upfield. Ferocious drive. It's another good chance for Leonardis. Couple chances today. Winding up there for the corner. Got to be up there for the corner, surely. Give it here. Give it here. Oh, you pig. Gets it back, Leonardis. Gonna be another corner. Just blocked as he was about to unleash another venomous drive. Get up there, Leo. There it is, 2-0 defeat in his debut. Playing in the position he ate, centre back. And he pushed on quite a lot. Don't know that he was really a good team player there. He probably played a little bit more for himself. A few touches, a couple shots that you saw. Not a lot of great action apart from that. Let's see what he comes away with. He gets a 6, which is one of the best scores on the team, really. The rest of the defence with 4.5, so they must have seen something in it. Let's see how the manager rates it, as he was pushing forward a lot. Perhaps he won't ever play him at centre-back again. That'll be the hope. But a bad home defeat for Sport Recife, and that basically nails them. They've got no chance of making the Copa Sudamericana this year. So 20 appearances now, 1.5 games for Sport Recife. It's been an interesting few games so far. We are now playing EC Bahia. And we're picked in the starting lineup. Centre back again. What are you doing to me, man? He's going to pick him out of position all the time. He'll be looking for a move. No doubt about it. Right, join you with action from this one then. Sport Recife's home ground. See if we can fare better. But we are playing centre-back yet again. Here we go then. Are we going to be involved anymore? Well, we know we're at centre-back. So we're not going to exactly have lots of action again. We're going to be gunno again. We're going to push forward and try and make things happen from the back. It's the only way he knows how to play, really. First early touch. Breaking forward. Early action, Leonardis! Oh, that was close. Lovely link-up play and come on to it. A good shot, and that was close. Close to opening his account. The Brazilians love it. They love a centre-back who's going to push on. And he will come forward, Leonardis. Once again, bundled over on the edge of the box. This time he get it, and a shot from Leonardis wins a corner kick. He's involved with everything here going forward, even though he's playing centre-back. Crazy stuff. Must be giving the manager heart murmurs on the touchline, I should think. Good half going forward as it comes to half-time. We're defending one here now. Huh? More conventional defending. Half-time, a great half from Leonardis. Involved in quite a lot going forward from the centre-back position. Whether that's what the manager wanted or not, he's had a very good half going forward and did nearly open his account. Second half to come. Struggling to get back now. He's burnt his engine. Brilliant tackle back there, though. Great from Leonardis. Leo. Right at the end here. Breaking pass. There's the whistle. What a game he's had. Unlucky not to score. Was instrumental in an awful lot of good moves. Playing the ball out from the back. Very good game from Leonardis. Should be at least a 6.5. I'd be disappointed if it's not. It's a 0-0 draw for Sport Recife. Leonardis, 6.5. Yeah, unlucky it wasn't man of the match. Okay, he didn't do a great deal of defending, but he was instrumental in bringing the ball out from the back and creating chances. And to be honest, he didn't give it away that many times a day. He would like the manager to give him a position in midfield in the next game, really. He's got him by the throat now in the manager's office, saying, are you going to play me in midfield, or am I going to have to choke the living daylights out of you? That's what he's saying to the manager. I don't know what we've got coming up here. We've got the Brazilian Cup first round. So this is a chance for Sport Recife to do something. Copa Brasileira. Very promising of late. Could make a real breakthrough. Give him more playing time. Leonardis going up in the ratings. Come on, give us some action then. As I choke to death. Picked in the starting lineup. Where are we playing? Bloody centre back with a big glowing beacon of an arrow up the 69 at centre back. We'll have a bit of a burst if we do well today then. Come on. This will probably be the last game of this episode 7. We are going to really go for it. Manager's trust level up to 86. He's having a real run of it at the moment. He loves him at centre back. Perhaps he wants him to be the man that pushes on from the back and takes all the chances. They do love an attacking centre back in Brazil. There's been a fair few over the years. And Leonardis, even though he's from Greece, he could make a name for himself in Brazil as being an attacking centre-back, perhaps. See if he can do anything here in this first leg of this cup match. Sporting Recife be looking for a performance here. Get going. Straight away, he's on the ball and he's pushing. Pushing where he likes to push. Leo gets it again. He's always the go-to man. He's always the one looking for the long ball upfield. Didn't pick anyone out this time. Good play. Still there. Leonardis! Oh! Thumping blow off the crossbar from Leo. Still there and in amongst them. Leonardis! Oh! Forces another save from the keeper. Desperate to break his duck here for Sport Recife. Brazilian crowd on their feet to this centre-back. They've never seen a centre-back push on like this before. Why he ain't out there for the corners, I'll never know. He should be. He looked to pick up this one, though. Come on, referee. Yeah, gets a free kick on the edge. Some other dumb waiter has it and puts it over the bar. Should have left it for Leonardis if you're going to produce shit like that. Christ. Looking for options. Not many available. Good half from Leonardis. Couple really good shots. That thunderous left-footed drive off the underside of the bar. Was the closest anyone come to scoring in that half. Done okay defensively. Not really been a lot to do. Sport Recife deserved to be a goal up, really. Even though the stats perhaps don't show it. Second half to come. Here he comes again from the back. Leonardis. What a run. What a shot. Oh, nearly Ross Bartley-esque from in the week against QPR. What a drive. That was close. That was close to bursting the net again on his wrong foot. Three really good chances. Well, not. They've all been long rangers, to be fair. Nothing's been a given. This one is, oh, he couldn't get it out from under his feet. What a run. Struggling to get back now. Little rainbow fit, the crowd love that. Centre back doing tricks. And driving into the space. Sees the run. What a ball. Oh, and he's missed. What a ball from Leonardis too. Picked him out a tree. How's he missed that? Would have been an assist for the centre-back. Brilliant football from Leonardis. Stepping out with a rainbow flick and then picking the man out. The dollop's gone and missed it. Here he is again. Driving forward, left foot drive. Oh! Five shots today. Only really at the target with one. That one's pulled across with the left. More shots than anyone else. Fancies himself. Really does. Keeps going out there and it keeps dropping. Leonardis will pick up the pieces there again. Oh, referee. Afters there. Leonardis, time running out. Good run again from the centre forward as he picked him out. He has. And he scored. And it's Leonardis' assist. Don't know what the goalie was doing, but Leonardis has set up the only goal of the game. And he will surely get an assist for that. What a great game he's had. Let's have a look at it. Bursting through. Wanted it. Driving out of defence. Don't know where he's got the energy from, but he's still going. Lovely little left-footed wedger. They should have dealt with that between them, to be honest. Comes off the back of the defender and dropped. We better get an assist for that. It's a bit lucky the way it came off number four's back. And number 11, Fazinho, was there to bag it. And set up a good home win in this FA Cup, well not FA Cup, Brazilian Cup. Not long ago now, Leo will drop back into a sweeper role. Oh, diving block between the two of them to make sure it stayed at 1-0. And they've hang on here. What rating for Leonardis? I'm expecting a 7. And I'm expecting an assist. This is going to be big trouble. 7.5. An absolute colossus performance from the back. Well, that should do the world of good in getting his rating up. Should have an assist as well. Let's see. His rating might shoot up after that. Because he was on one of those special big reds, don't forget. Don't care about that. Who we got in the next round? We've got to get through this first. Still 71. They haven't given him assists for that. Why has he not had an assist for that? That is criminal. I'm going to go and bomb everybody responsible for not giving him assists there. Deserve the assist for sure. We'll just see if his rating goes up before the next game. He won't be in the national squad in Greece, I shouldn't think. Not yet. Made rapid progress after making the most of his chances, Leonardis. There he is. Certainly did. And he's got in the national squad. That's big news. Selected in the Greece national squad for the first time, Leonardis. What a great episode 7 you've had. So let's have a look where he's going to play. He's going to be on the bench there, but at least he's in there. And he's gone up to a 75. That's the big news. Up to a 75 now. So, 22 matches into his career. He's had a whopping increase of 3. And he's got national honours with Greece. All to come in episode 8. We look forward to that. And he's also working towards long-range drive, you can see. But it's the international call-up that's a big thing. Manager's trust level up to 89 as well. A great episode for the mighty Leonardis. And only better things to come, surely. Thanks for joining me. Spartan out.